Good morning, dear students. Welcome to our offline class. At present, I am in the 8th standard social study class. In the previous class, we started the one more important South Indian dynasty, that is Rashtrakuta dynasty. We already know that in that Rashtrakuta dynasty, who is the founder, which is the capital city, and who were the prominent kings, and what kind of they are given more importance to their administration. Now it is the time to understand their contributions of Rashtrakutas, especially in the field of literature. So everyone should take this one. It is a very important for your examination, so you have to keep in mind. One more side, you should write the name of the authors and their works. Okay, it is a literature part. Here, literature. In this literature part, we have the very first one. First literaturist, Trivikrama. Trivikrama. Trivikrama wrote Nalachampu. Nalachampu. Okay, the second one, it is in a Sanskrit language. The second one, Halayuda. Halayuda was the one of the great scholar in Rashtrakuta dynasty. He wrote Kavi Rahasya. Kavi Rahasya. And next scholar, Jinasena. Jinasena, he was a mathematician. Jinasena, not only Jinasena, here are so many other. Jinasena, Mahaviracharya. Mahaviracharya. Then these both scholars are considered as mathematicians. Mathematicians, both are. Next one, Shakatayana. Shakatayana. Shakatayana was the scholar. He had a very biggest knowledge in the field of grammar. Grammarian. Grammarian. Okay, the next one is the Gunabhadra. The next one is Gunabhadra. Gunabhadra. And Veerasena. And one more scholar is there, Veerasena. Both are scholars. Scholars, both are quarter age in the field of Amoghavarsha Nrupatunga, the great king of the Rashtrakuta dynasty. Okay, the next one is there, that is Pampa. You already know that. Pampa, he is considered as Adikavi. Adikavi. Do you know about that? For what reason Pampa considered as Adikavi? Because he was the pioneer person to start the literature in Kannada. That's why he is considered as Adikavi, Pampa. Okay. He wrote what kind of work he had done? Vikramarjuna Vijaya. Vikramarjuna Vijaya. This is the great work composed by the Adikavi Pampa. The next, here, and one more work is there, that is Adi Purana. Adi Purana and Vikramarjuna Vijaya, both are the major work of Pampa. Then Ubhaya Kavi Kamala Ravi, this is the award. Who got this award? This award got by Ponna, another diamond of the Kannada literature. That's why you have to understand. He had Udaya Kavi Kamala Ravi. That is the title he had. That is Ponna. And one more point, next we have to understand. He composed Shantinatha Purana. Ponna wrote Shantinatha Purana. He had the one more title, that is Ubhaya Kavi Kamala Ravi. And then Sri Vijaya, he wrote Kaviraja Marga. Some of the historians explained about that Kaviraja Marga composed by Amoghavarsha Nrupatunga. But there is a confusion is there. Amoghavarsha Nrupatunga was the great king of the Rashtrakuta dynasty, but he had given patronage to Sri Vijaya. Sri Vijaya was the original writer of Kaviraja Marga. Okay, in that in detail information is there about Karnataka history. That's why it is the first literature work in Kannada language. Okay, we have to understand that point. So this is the, and one more point we have to understand. Nadoja, that is the word we have to again and again hearing there. What is the meaning of that? We have to understand brief information about that. The Kannada University, it is located in Hampi, so has been awarding the title of Nadoja. They are giving the award Nadoja in the memory of the first poet Pampa. We already know that Pampa, he was considered as Adikavi. Why? Because he was the pioneer person to start the literature work in Kannada language. That's why he is considered as Adi Kavi. For his memory, they are awarding, that is Nadoja. Here Nadu, that means Karnataka. Ja means he was born person. He was the born person to create the history in the literature. That's why that is the meaning of Nadoja. That award issued by the Hampi University. Okay, so to great achievers in Karnataka every year. It is a brief information we have to understand. Once again, I repeat all the literature work of the Rashtrakuta dynasty. Once again, here these are all considered as scholars and their works. Trivikrama wrote Nalachampu. It is already, I explained about that. It is in the Sanskrit language. Then Halayuda. Halayuda was a great scholar. He wrote Kavirahasya. And Jinasena and Mahaviracharya both are considered as mathematicians. And they are given more contribution to the in the field of mathematics. The next one is that Shakatayana. He was the great Sanskrit grammarian. That means he had great knowledge in the grammar of Sanskrit language. The next one, Gunabhadra and Veerasena, both are scholars and they are patronaged in the field of Amoghavarsha Nrupatunga. Okay, already we know that the Kannada literature has three diamonds. In that, two diamonds in the Rashtrakuta dynasty. One diamond is there, that is Pampa, and one more, that is Ponna. Ponna has awarded Ubhaya Kavi and Kamala Ravi. The same manner here, Pampa had awarded Adi Kavi. So, dear students, I hope to you understand about the literature work of the Rashtrakuta dynasty. In the next class, we have to understand about the Chalukyas of Kalyana. Okay, thank you so much.